Granulomas disease, as sarcoidosis, Crohn's disease, and tuberculosis, they all affect different tissues, but they have one thing in common. They all characterized by formation of granulomas. And recall that granuloma are composed of macrophages, epithelioid cells that are actually activated macrophages with a shape quite similar to epithelial cells. Macrophages and epithelioid cells can fuse and form giant cells. And also granuloma has TNB lymphocytes and areas of necrosis and fibrosis. So basically a granuloma is aggregation of macrophages in a particular area. And the specific feature is that macrophages have the specific enzyme that is also present in kidney tissue and placenta. They all have 25-hydroxyvitamin D3 1-alpha hydroxylase, also known as cytochrome P27B1. This enzyme converts calcidiol to the calcitriol, which is the active form of vitamin D. So basically macrophages are capable to produce calcitriol, and calcitriol stimulates calcium absorption in intestine and kidney, and also it mobilizes calcium from bone tissue, so calcitriol increases serum calcium level. And in case of kidney, the production of calcitriol is stimulated by parathyroid hormone, and the activity of this enzyme is inhibited by high blood calcium level or by high calcitriol level. And recall that calcitriol is degraded in the kidney by 25-hydroxyvitamin D3-24-hydroxylase enzyme, also called cytochrome P24A1, to calcitroic acid. But in contrast to kidneys, the activity of 25-hydroxyvitamin D3-1-alpha-hydroxylase enzyme in macrophages is not regulated by parathyroid hormone, and this enzyme is not inhibited by high blood calcium levels or even by high calcitriol levels. So, in case of macrophages, there is no normal negative feedback mechanism. In macrophages, 1-alpha-hydroxylase enzyme is sensitive only to immunological stimuli. The activity of this enzyme is stimulated by pro-inflammatory substances as lipopolysaccharides, interferon gamma, and interleukin 2. And exactly interferon gamma disrupts calcitriol negative feedback regulation, and in addition to this, interferon gamma inhibits 25-hydroxyvitamin D3-24-hydroxylase enzyme, and by this it prevents calcitriol inactivation. Together, these effects result in increase in blood calcitriol level that cause proportional increase in blood calcium level. And also, as we see, the more severe is inflammation, the higher is pro-inflammatory cytokine secretion, the more substantial becomes hypercalcemia. So that's why hypercalcemia is a characteristic feature of granulomas disease.